Hey now, Rodney R. Dixon here, and today I'm going to show you how to set up an Apple ID for use with an iPhone, iPad, or iPod product using iOS 5 without having to install or use iTunes and without having to create one through your device. Essentially, we'll be doing so through a web browser. So what happens is you buy your new iOS device, you take it home, you unpackage it, you find that there's no wall charger included with the device, unless you bought one separately or you got a bundle package deal. Essentially all you have is a USB cable. Now you have to charge your device, and the way you charge your iOS device is through a USB connection. I'm going to be speaking of this through the perspective of a Windows user, because I am a Windows user. I can't comment or tell you how the devices interface with a Macintosh computer. I don't know, I don't use them. Okay, that being said, take home your device, you have to charge it, you plug it into your USB port on your Windows-based PC. The one nice thing about iOS devices is they don't automatically install software onto your Windows-based machine. Essentially, the device is recognized as a removable storage device. Think of a USB key or a USB hard disk, something of this nature. It essentially is regarded by Windows as such, as well as having camera capabilities. Now, when the prompt comes up that you have a camera, you can essentially choose not to bind any specific program to that camera in Windows by clicking cancel, and it won't bother you, so no issues there, at which point your device is charging, which is great. So you power on your iOS device, and now you have to go through an initial setup. You do so by providing some personal information, by choosing some default personalizations, some preferences, what have you, at which point you'll hit a roadblock. You have to register your new iOS device with Apple. You could do so in two methods. You could do so through iTunes, or you could do so through a wireless network. I myself have no use for iTunes. iTunes is generally used if you want to purchase music or videos through the iTunes Music Store. If you want to convert music, including existing MP3s, to a format that can be read by your iOS device, because an iOS device can't read MP3s by default, they need to be converted in iTunes. However, in my case, I won't be using any of these functionalities, and on a Windows-based machine, iTunes is generally very bloaty. It takes up a lot of system resources, a lot of network resources, slows down your computer. Frankly, I have no need for it, so I'm not going to install it. That being said, you have two options. Once again, register through iTunes, or register through your wireless device. Here you hit another roadblock. If your wireless network, like mine, has two sets of protection, you have your encrypted password, and you have wireless MAC filtering. If you have these two options, you have to disable wireless MAC filtering before you could access the network on your iOS device. Let me explain why. The way wireless MAC filtering works is every wireless device has its own unique MAC address. What wireless MAC filtering gives you the ability to do is, on your wireless network, you can state to your wireless network, these specific addresses of these specific devices, I know what they are, and therefore I want to grant them access to the network. Any other devices not on my wireless MAC filter list cannot access my network, which is brilliant, and it works great for filtering out any unwanted intruders on your network, wirelessly anyway. Unfortunately, the way the hierarchy of the initial setup of your iOS device works, they don't give you access to your device's wireless MAC filter address until you go through the initial setup. That being said, since you're in the initial setup and you can't access the system settings until the initial setup is completed, you can't access the device's wireless MAC filter address, can add that wireless MAC filter address to your wireless MAC filter list, and therefore you can access the network. So what I had to do in my case is I had to access my router's wireless settings, security settings. I had to disable wireless MAC filtering, at least temporarily, so I could get my new iOS device on the network. I left the password protection on because they still allow you to enter a password. They just won't give you the device's wireless MAC address. So, disabled wireless MAC filtering, left the password protection, through the iOS device, connected to the wireless network, put in my password. Great, I have access to the network. It registers the device with Apple. Great. Go on with the registration process, or the initial setup, I should say. Proceed to a point where I hit another roadblock. At this point, it's the Apple ID issue. I need to register an Apple ID with the device. If I don't, I cannot proceed in the setup, I cannot access the device. Okay, I need an Apple ID. Once again, they propose two methods. They propose doing it through iTunes. I don't want to install iTunes. That option's off the table. The other option is through the device itself. You could access the registration pages to create an Apple ID and what have you. I could tell you right now from what I experienced. The process was very cumbersome. I hit a lot of error messages. The error messages were vague. They didn't really tell me what was going on, why my registration wasn't going through. And I found it rather frustrating. Luckily, there's a third option, which they don't seem to advertise or let you know exists, but as far as I'm concerned, it's the simplest option. It's not easy, and I can't say if any option's easier than the other, because they all seem to work poorly, but for me, it was the simplest option and the most effective. It's doing it through a web browser. So, you open up your favorite web browser, you go to the following address, appleid.apple.com. Page loads up. Slowly, but it does load. At which point you click right here, create an Apple ID, and you go through the process of creating your Apple ID. I could tell you right now, huge warning, when creating your Apple ID, only use common case letters, lowercase letters. For example, when I originally made my Apple ID, and now this caused problems, I did it as follows, because this is the way I generally write my email address, with a capital R in Rodney, and a capital D in Dixon, for RodneyDixon at yahoo.com. The Apple ID registration process didn't warn me that it didn't like this email address. Instead, it made me go through the whole process. Once you finish the Apple ID registration, it sends you an email to your email address with a link that you got to click on to verify, at which point I received this error. This email address is no longer associated with Apple ID. What does this mean? Who knows? The message is so vague I can't make sense of it. I did some research on ways to fix this issue, because I didn't have an Apple ID prior with this email registered to it, so I can't say what's going on. I can't figure out what's going on. What do? I did some research. A lot of people experienced this issue when they upgraded from iOS 4 to iOS 5, and they had current Apple IDs. So what they could do is they could go into their accounts, their Apple ID accounts online, and they could change the email address they registered to their Apple ID, and that seemed to solve the problem. Of course, I didn't have this option because this is a whole new Apple ID. I don't have an Apple ID. I didn't have an Apple ID prior to today. What could I do? This is the way I solved the problem. First, I went back to appleid.apple.com. Went through create an Apple ID. Typed out all the exact same information, just this time writing my Apple ID email address as so. All in common case. RodneyDixon at yahoo.com. No capitals whatsoever. At which point, I went through the registration process, clicked on, entered the CAPTCHA at the bottom, clicked on accept to check marks and continue, what have you. I was informed at that point that my Apple ID is already registered to this email address. What do I do? At that point, I went to this address. iforgot.apple.com. So that's iforgot.apple.com. At which point I was then prompted with this. Enter your Apple ID to get started. Well, instead of entering the Apple ID with the capitals, I entered a common case, as so. RodnDixon@yahoo.com. I clicked next. I went through the process of restoring my Apple ID, got sent another verification email, clicked on the link in the verification email, and it solved the problem. At which point I could then input my Apple ID, my newly confirmed, my newly verified Apple ID and password into my iOS device, proceed with the initial setup, complete the initial setup, and finally have access to the device. So that's what worked for me, that's what got me out of the hole, and what got my Apple ID registered, verified, and working. I hope this helps, I hope you have better luck than I did, and all the best.